Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjali Ammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvanni. I am happy to meet you again in the video lecture on the subject Design of Transmission Systems. And this is lecture number 6.4. We are going to solve few more problems on the helical gear design using the PSD design data book. In the earlier two lectures also, we solved a problem in the helical gear. We continue with the two more problems in the lecture from the Anna University question paper. The learning outcome to the lecture: at the end of the lecture, the student will be able to design helical gear using the PSG design data book. The example number 5 from the May 2008 question paper: a helical gear with a 30 degree helix angle has to transmit 35 kilowatt at 1500 rpm with a speed reduction ratio 2.5. If the pinion has 24 teeth, determine the necessary module, pitch diameter, face width for 20 degree full depth teeth. Assume 15 Ni 2 CR1 MO15 material for both the pinion and the wheel. So we write down the given data. So power equal to 35 kilowatt, pinion speed 1500 rpm, speed reduction 2.5, Z1 24 and helix angle beta equal to 30 degree. Then calculate the speed ratio. The speed ratio is given in the problem, 2.5. The material for the gear and the pinion, it is also given in the problem, 15 Ni 2 CR1 MO15 for both the gear and the pinion. So the property for the material from the PSG data book, page number 1.40, tensile strength sigma E equal to 10,400 kilogram force per centimeter square, BHN, Brinell hardness number 630, cast hardened. Next, we calculate the torque transmitted, torque to be transmitted by the helical gear, MT equal to 97,420 into power in kilowatt divided by the pinion speed. Substituting 97,400 into 35 divided by 1500 equal to 2273.1 kilogram force centimeter. Then we calculate the design torque. To calculate the design torque, we require the KKD value. So initially we take 1.3. K is the load concentration factor and the KD is the dynamic load factor. So design torque MT within bracket equal to torque into KKD 2273.1 into 1.3 equal to 2955.1 kilogram force centimeter. Then we take the equivalence Young's modulus for the steel, alloy steel, E equal to 2.15 into 10 power 6 kilogram force per centimeter square from table number 9, page 8.14. Then take the psi value initially 0.6 for our calculation. Then we take from table number 16 for surface hardened alloy steel, CR equal to 63 and HRC equal to Rockwell C hardness number 280 and life factor for life factor equal to 1. Then we calculate the design surface compressive stress, sigma C equal to CR HRC KCL, 63 into 280 equal to 17,640 kilogram force per centimeter square. Then we calculate the center distance. So the equation A is greater than or equal to I plus 1 cubic root of 0.7 divided by sigma c whole square into U into MT divided by I into psi. So substituting numerical values, A is greater than or equal to 2.5 plus 1 into cubic root of 0.7 divided by 17,640 into 2.15 into 10 power 6 into 2955.1 divided by 2.5 into 0.6. The center distance A equal to 6.59 centimeter. The value should be higher than 6.59 centimeter. Then we take from the page number 8.19, K sigma stress concentration factor equal to 1.2, factor of safety from table number 20 equal to 2, and sigma minus 1 endurance limit. So we calculate the endurance limit for the alloy steel, 0.35 sigma u plus 1200, 0.35 into 10,400 plus 1200 equal to 4840 kilogram force per centimeter square. Then life factor for bending equal to 1. Now we calculate the design bending stress, sigma b within bracket 1.4 kbl divided by n into k sigma into sigma minus 1. So substituting 1.4 into 1 divided by 2 into 1.2 into 4840, so that is equal to 2823.3 kilogram force per centimeter square. Then we take Z1 equal to 24 given in the problem. Then we calculate the virtual number of teeth for helix angle beta equal to 30 degree. ZV equal to Z1 divided by cos cube beta, which is 24 divided by cos cube 30 equal to 37. Now, we take the form factor for ZV equal to 37, YV equal to 0.38. Then we take psi m equal to b by m equal to phase width divided by the module, which is 10. Then we calculate the minimum normal module. So, mn is greater than or equal to 1.15 cos beta into cubic root of design torque divided by design bending stress, form factor psi m into Z1. So, substituting all the numerical values, mn is greater than or equal to 1.15 cos 30 into cubic root of 4840 divided by 2823.3 into 0.38 into 10 into 24 equal to 0.26 centimeter. So, this is the normal module. Now, we take the nearest higher module, standard module from table number 1, page number 8.2, m equal to 3 mm or 0.3 centimeter. Then we calculate the module and the axial pitch. Module equal to normal module divided by cos beta. So, 0.3 divided by cos 30 equal to 0.346. And axial pitch PA equal to pi into mn divided by sin beta, which is 3.14 into 0.3 divided by sin 30 equal to 1.88 centimeter. Then minimum number of teeth on the pinion, it is given 24. And number of teeth on the gear Z equal to I into Z1, 2.5 into 24 equal to 60. Then pitch diameter we calculate. So, PCD of the pinion M into Z1 0.346 into 24 equal to 8.3 centimeter. PCD of the gear D2 equal to M into Z2 0.346 into 60 equal to 20.76 centimeter. And center distance A equal to D1 plus D2 divided by 2. So, 8.3 plus 20.76 divided by 2 equal to 14.53 centimeter. Then we calculate the phase width. So, here we have three equations to calculate the phase width. So, B equal to psi into A 0.6 into 14.53, which is 8.72 centimeter. B is also equal to psi m into m, psi m equal to 10, module equal to 0.346 equal to 3.19 centimeter, and B equal to 1.15 into axial pitch, 1.15 into 1.88 equal to 2.16 centimeter. So, we take the highest value of the phase width, B equal to 8.72 centimeter. Then we calculate the pitch line velocity for our checking. So, first calculation for checking purpose. So, the parameter for checking purpose. So, we have to check the gear stress, bending stress and the compressive stress for safety. So, V equal to pi D1N divided by 60, pi into 0.083 into 1500 divided by 60 equal to 6.5 meters per second. Now, we take the KKD value and calculate the design torque. So, K value load concentration factor from table number 14 equal to 1.1. K equal to 1.1 for psi p equal to B by D1 equal to 8.72 divided by 8.3 equal to 1.05. And KD dynamic load factor equal to 1.15 from table number 15. For IS quality 8 and the velocity equal to 6.5 meters per second. Now, the design torque for the designed gear. So, we calculate the parameter of the gear, designed the gear, and for the designed gear, the design torque MT equal to the twisting moment or the torque to be transmitted into KKD. So, 2273.1 into 1.1 into 1.15 equal to 2875.5 kilogram per centimeter. Then we have to check for the compressive stress. So, the equation is 0.7 into I plus 1 divided by A into square root of I plus 1 into E into design torque divided by I into B. The value should be less than or equal to the design compressive stress what we calculated earlier. So, substituting numerical values 0.7 into 2.5 plus 1 divided by 14.53 into square root of 2.5 plus 1 into 2.15 into 10 power 6 into 2875.5 divided by 2.5 into 8.72, the value is 5312.3, which is very much lower than the 17,640. So, the actual compressive stress is less than the design compressive stress. So, the design is safe. Then we check for the bending stress. So, sigma b equal to 0.7 into I plus 1 divided by A mn b into yv into design torque. The value should be less than or equal to design bending stress what we calculated earlier. So, substituting numerical values, sigma b equal to 0.7 into 2.5 plus 1 divided by 14.53 into 0.3 into 8.7872 into 0.38, which into 2875.5. So the answer is 487.7, which is very much lower than 2823.3. So the design is also safe here for the bending stress. So the actual bending stress is less than the design bending stress. So the design is safe. Now we write down the specification of the drive. So we completed the design of the gear drive as per the PSG data book procedure. Now we write down the data. Module 3.46 millimeter, center distance 14.53 centimeter, number of teeth on the pinion 24, number of teeth on the gear 60, diameter PCD of the pinion 8.3 centimeter, PCD of the gear 20.76 centimeter, face width 8.72 centimeter. And the addendum 2 into FO into M, 2 into 1 into 3.46 equal to 6.92 millimeter. Dedendum 2 into FO plus C into M equal to 2 into 1 plus 0.25 into 3.46 equal to 8.65 millimeter. Tooth height addendum plus dedendum equal to 6.92 plus 8.65 equal to 15.57 millimeter. And the tip circle diameter of the pinion, PCD plus addendum equal to 8.3 plus 0.692 equal to 8.99 centimeter. And tip circle diameter of the gear, PCD plus addendum equal to 20.76 plus 0.692 equal to 21.45 centimeter. So at the end of the problem, you write down the answers for the design so that you will get the full credit. The last problem in the helical gear design. Example number 6 from May 2005 question paper. A pair of helical gears subjected to the moderate shock loading to transmit 37.5 kilowatt and at 1750 rpm of the pinion. The speed reduction ratio is 4.25 and the helix angle is 15 degree. The service is continuous and the teeth is 20 degree full depth in the normal plane. Design the gear assuming life of 10,000 hours. We write down the given data. So power equal to 37.5 kilowatt, speed equal to 1750 rpm, I speed reduction ratio 4.25, helix angle 15 degree, the pressure angle 20 degree, life is 10,000 hours. And we are given the speed ratio 4.25. So speed ratio is 4.25. And we have to select the material. Here I select the C45 as the material for both the pinion and the gear. Then torque to be transmitted. So MT equal to 97,420 into power in kilowatt divided by the N1. So 97,400 into 37.5 divided by 1750 equal to 2087.6 kilogram per centimeter. Now we have to calculate the design torque. So for calculating design torque, we require KKD value. So initially we assume KKD equal to 1.3. K is the load consolidation factor and KD is the dynamic load factor. We take the value later on for our checking. Now the design torque equal to MT into KKD 2087.6 into 1.3 equal to 2713.8 kilogram per centimeter. Then we take the equivalent Young's modulus for the steel, which is 2.15 in 10 power 6 kilogram force per centimeter square from the table number 9, page number 8.14 in the PSG data book. Then we take the psi equal to B by A equal to 0.6. And we take the properties of the C45 material. So CR equal to 55, HRC equal to 230. Life and number of cycles we have to calculate. We are given 10,000 hours. So 60 into N into T equal to 60 into 1750 into 10,000. Equal to 1.05 in 10 power 9. So for the life of the gear greater than 10 power 7 cycles, the life factor equal to 1 from the table number 17. Then we calculate the design surface compressive stress, sigma c equal to CR HRC KCL, which is CR 55 into 230 into 1 equal to 12,650 kilogram force per centimeter square. Then we calculate the center distance for the helical gear. The equation is A is greater than or equal to I plus 1 into square cubic root of 0.7 divided by design compressive stress whole square into E into MT divided by I into psi. A is greater than or equal to 4.25 plus 1 into cubic root of 0.7 divided by 12,650 whole square into 2.15 into 10 power 6. into 2713.8 divided by 4.25 into 0.6, which is 10.04 centimeter. Then to calculate the design bending stress, we take the parameters K sigma stress concentration factor from table number 21. It is 1.2. N factor of safety from table number 20. It is 2. Endurance limit for the steel 0.22 into sigma u plus sigma y plus 500. So 0.22 into 7000 plus 3600 plus 500 equal 2832 kilogram force per centimeter square. The tensile strength and the yield strength, they are 7000 and 3600 respectively for the C45 steel. The life factor equal to 1. So calculate the design bending stress sigma b within bracket equal to 1.4 into KBL divided by N into K sigma into sigma minus 1. So substituting 1.4 into 1 by 2 into 1.2 into 2832 equal to 1652 kilogram force centimeter square. The number of teeth in the pinion, initially we have to take 14. So it should be minimum 14 to 20. So number, the virtual number of teeth for the helix angle beta equal to 15 degree. So, Zb equal to Z1 divided by cos cube beta, which is 14 divided by cos cube 15 equal to 15.5. Now, we take the form factor Yv equal to 0.295 for Zb equal to 16. Then, we take psi m, which is B by m equal to 10 for our calculation. And now, we calculate the minimum normal module. So, mn is greater than or equal to 1.15 into cos beta into cubic root of design torque divided by design bending stress into form factor into psi m into Z1. So, substituting numerical values, 1.15 into cos 15 into cubic root of 2713.8 divided by 165 to 1652 into 0.295 into 10 into 14, which is 0.38 centimeter. The module should be greater than or equal to 0.38 centimeter. We take the nearest higher standard module from table number 1, page number 8.2, m equal to 4 millimeter or 0.4 centimeter. Then the module and the axial pitch we calculate, module equal to mn divided by cos beta, 0.4 divided by cos 15 equal to 0.414 centimeter. Then the axial pitch, pa equal to pi into mn. So, pi into mn divided by sin beta into 3.1, which is equal to 3.14 into 0.4 divided by sin 15 equal to 4.85 centimeter. Then we calculate the number of teeth on the pinion. So, 2a by I plus 1 into m. So, substituting 2 into 10.04 divided by 4.25 plus 1 into 0.414 equal to 9.2. We have to take minimum 12 teeth for manufacturing. So, number of teeth we take Z1 equal to 12 and the gear, number of teeth on the gear Z2 equal to I into Z1, 4.25 into 12 equal to 51. Then we calculate the PCD of the gear. PCD of the pinion D1 equal to M into Z1, 0.414 into 12 equal to 5 centimeter. PCD of the gear M into Z2, which is 0.414 into 51 equal to 21.11 centimeter. And the center distance A equal to D1 plus D2 by 2. So, 5 plus 21.11 divided by 2 equal to 13.05 centimeter. Then we calculate the face width of the gear. We have three equations to calculate the face width. B equal to psi into A, which is 0.6 into 13.05 equal to 7.83 centimeter. B is also equal to psi m into m, 10 into 0.414 equal to 4.14 centimeter. B is equal to 1.15 into axial pitch, 1.15 into 4.85 equal to 5.6 centimeter. The highest value among the three values is 7.83 centimeter. We fix the actual face width is 7.683 centimeter. For checking, first we calculate the pitch line velocity, V equal to pi D1N divided by 60. So, pi into 0.05 into 1750 divided by 60 equal to 4.6 meters per second. Now, we take the KKD value and calculate the design torque. So, K load concentration factor equal to 1.25 for psi P B by D1 equal to 1.6. KD dynamic load factor KD equal to 1 for IS quality 6 and velocity 4.6 meters per second. Now, the design torque MT for the designed gear is twisting moment into KKD 2087.6 into 1.25 into 1 equal to 2609.5 kilogram 4 centimeter. Then we check for the compressive stress. Sigma C is equal to 0.7 I plus 1 by A into square root of I plus 1 into E into MT divided by IB. The value should be less than or equal to design compressive stress. So, sigma C, substitute numerical value is 0.7 into 4.25 plus 1 divided by 13.05 into square root of 4.25 into 2.15 into 10 power 6 into 2609.5 divided by 4.25 into 7.83. The value is 8378.2, which is very much lower than 12,650. So, the actual compressive stress of the gear is less than the design compressive stress. So, the design is safe. Then we have to check for the bending stress. Sigma B equal to 0.7 into I plus 1 divided by A into MN B into YV form factor into the design torque. The value should be less than or equal to the design bending stress. So, sigma B equal to 0.7 into 4.25 plus 1 divided by 13.05 into 0.4 into 7.83 into 0.21 into design torque 2609.5, which is 1117.3, which is less than 1652. So, the for bending stress also the design is safe. So, the actual bending stress is less than the design bending stress. So, the design is safe. Now, we write down the design details of the helical gear. Module 4.14 mm, center distance 13.05 cm. Number of teeth on the pinion Z1 12, Z2 number of teeth on the gear 51. PCD of the pinion 5 cm, PCD of the gear 21.1 cm. Face width 7.83 cm. Addendum 2FO into M equal to 2 into 1 into 4.14 equal to 8.28 mm. Dedendum 2 into FO plus C into M. That is 2 into 1 plus 0.25 into 4.14 equal to 10.35 mm. Tooth height equal to addendum plus dedendum equal to 8.28 plus 10.35 equal to 18.63 mm. And the tip circle diameter of the pinion. So, pitch circle diameter plus addendum. So, 5 plus 0.828 equal to 5.83 cm. Tip circle diameter of the gear. Pitch circle diameter plus addendum 21.1 plus 0.828 equal to 21.93 cm. So, you have the practice of writing the result at the end of every problem so that you will get the due credit for the answer. So, we stop here. So, these are all the books I published in the mechanical engineering subject, and I am uploading the video lectures for all the subjects in the YouTube channel. You subscribe to the channel, use the videos for your better learning. So, thank you for watching. Please post your comments on the comments box for improvement. So, you can contact me for any clarification on the subject using my mail ID or WhatsApp number. So, thank you. We'll meet again in another video lecture on the subject design of transmission system.